call it naivety, I don't know. It just doesn't make sense. So anyway, I realized the other day, I've taught yoga half my life. I'm like, I know you're probably thinking, she can't be a day over 40, but but no, I have. I've taught for 28 years, now 54, and I think, wow, I'd like to sustain that to hit 30 years, I really would. But I just, I'm hoping that things will turn out rightly for us, and I keep hoping for that. And I feel like it just keeps snowballing and gets worse and worse. Anyway, as I said, we did survey the staff, and it came out equal that we wanted plan time and salary increase. So I don't feel ashamed for wanting that. I feel proud of the hard work we're doing and for expecting that in a way that is part of our hard work. I don't feel entitled, but I do feel like it's deserving. And I know a lot of us, we all do, that teach here. So I hope to remain committed to Parchment for my 30 years or more. It would be great. It's just hard right now because it doesn't feel like that we're valued or appreciated. And I know you say we are, but it just doesn't feel that way. Thank you.
I do have a concern here again, and I just want to try to ask you to listen to it. Take it from there, I guess. Over four years ago, due to budget concerns, a new contract was put into place to meet those concerns about not being able to balance the budget. And it sacrificed the some of the quality of the education being offered in the district to try to meet that financial goal of expenditures, not out distancing revenue. So 4 years have gone by now, 4 years or more, and over those 4 years, if you look at it, student enrollment, we've been told, has gone down every year. Last year, we just heard in the audit that our expenditures were over $300,000 more than our revenues, in spite of cutting eight positions, eliminating eight teaching positions over 4 years ago, and eliminating the plan period in order to make that possible, both without any doubt reducing the quality of education being offered in the district. And that was for the budget, and after 4 years of that, we're right where we were, as far as I can see. And so the remedy seemed to be, let's look at it, let's do it again. Three more positions were cut this past year, and nothing new for the compensation for the teachers, as far as the value goes. Every person teaching the district increased their workload by 15% at minimum when this went into place, and there was not a 15% increase. So the district, as I calculated out this summer, trying to go by what was I could figure out from the district's negotiators if they could calculate their value costs, turned out to be about from $1.5 to $2 million if the district value they gained from people teaching here taking on that additional workload for 4 years without going into a fifth. plan period, we heard that that's priority and that's good. But in his letters of agreement, we never once were given one that guaranteed it was going to take place. We were just guaranteed that there would be a committee formed to try to work it out, try to come up with a plan for it, to present that. But there was never any guarantee given. And so, so as a result of all this, it seems that we've lowered the educational quality now, just so that we can continue to lose students and spend more than we take in as a district. So why do it again? There's concern. How do we expect that's going to be any different this time around than it was the past 4 years? Been overused, that definition of insanity, doing the same thing again and again, expecting different results. We were told that multiple times at professional development stuff years ago, but yet that seems to be kind of where we're headed here. So, what's the solution? I just want to throw out there, Mark Cuban, successful businessman, got his 12 fundamental rules. Rule number 6, spend liberally on recruiting employees who play an essential role. He says, know your core competencies and focus on being great at them. Pay up for people in your core competencies. Get the best. Seen the results for 4 years going into a pit. We're told again the student enrollment dropped again this year. We're told again that that's going to hurt the budget, that the budget was counting on an increase. So why do the same thing again? Young, stable families have young children looking for places, good places, to have their children educated. You increase quality instruction and quality education, it will bring more families. The other part is this as well, and this is from the PEA side of it. Again, 4 years ago, the contract was proposed to us. And as a union, as a membership, it didn't look good. It got voted down. Came back within a week, pretty much the same thing again. Saying again, it's got to go in, it's going to be cuts and this and that to make things ends meet. And so, it got voted in. Against what we knew, hired us. We hired some of us. Some of us were hired long before. But we were all hired for our professional expertise. Educational professional expertise. How can we vote yes? How can we say this is good when it's pretty much the same thing it was 4 years ago? We are.